Awesome. Thank you, Carly. That was awesome. Thanks for starting the day with so much fun and so much sound and so much joy. Welcome, everybody, to our virtual Havdalah. Just a little reminder on our Zoom rules for today. Everybody, your mics will be muted until the end of the program. But I do encourage you to dance and jump around and move a little bit, as when we move into the songs after our blessings, we might highlight your video to show off how good your dance moves are. Just a reminder that this is being recorded. If you don't want to be popped up on the microphone or on the camera, just turn off your video. And then additionally, if you need to get in touch with anybody during it, either tap your screen or press Alt on a computer, or just move your mouse to the bottom of the screen, and it'll bring up your controls where you can access chat functions, etc., to get in touch with people if you need to. But I'm going to turn it on over to Steph, and let's get this party started.
Good morning, everyone. I'm so happy to see you all here. It's really exciting that everyone's here on Tuesday morning to say hello and do Havdalah with us. Havdalah is when we welcome the new week. We separate Shabbat from the rest of the week with a few wonderful blessings over a cup of wine, over some spices, and over a beautiful braided candle. And we're going to listen to Carly sing the blessings as I do the deed, or the blessings, or I do the actions with the ritual objects. And without further ado, we are going to start the blessings and lilies with Carly. Take it away, Carly.
Thank you.
right now, if we listen really closely, we are going to extinguish the flame of the Havdalah candle into the wine or grape juice, which will be the official separation of Shabbat from the rest of the week. So listen closely for that sizzle sound. Here we go. Shavuot Tov.
Shavuot Tov.
All right, let's do our Havdalah song that we all love. We're going to all sit down, and I'm going to aim the camera down so you can all see me. And we are going to put our hands like this, and we are going to wiggle our fingers and raise our yadayim up to the sky like this. And then we're going to take three fingers, echad, shtayim, shalosh, and we're going to say, when three stars are shining in the sky, Maya Fei Hayom Shabbat Shalom, then we wave Shabbat goodbye. Maya Fei Hayom Shabbat Shalom. And here's our favorite part. Are we ready? Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom, Havdalah, Havdalah, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom, Havdalah, Havdalah, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom. Let's do it one more time, a little faster. Here we go. Are you ready? Big deep breath in. Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom, Havdalah, Havdalah, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom, Havdalah, Havdalah, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom. Woof! Let's do one more time. Let's do it really slowly. Ready? Really deep breathing. Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom, Havdalah, Havdalah, Hala, 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 Hala,
and Shabbat
Shalom. Havdalah, Havdalah, Hala, 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 and Shabbat Shalom. That was awesome, my friend. Shavuot Tov. Welcome to the new week. And now, Carly is going to take it away with Eliyahu Hanavi.
Awesome. Here we go. Eliyahu Hanavi.
Awesome. We have a very special guest reading us a very special story this week. I'm going to turn the mic over to Shelley, who's going to give us a great story to kick off our week.
Hi, everyone. Today I brought you my favorite story, Something from Nothing. This is an old Jewish folktale. So I'm going to read the words and then I'll show you the pictures, okay? When Joseph was a baby, his grandfather made him a wonderful blanket. To keep him warm and cozy and chase away his bad dreams. But as Joseph grew older, the wonderful blanket grew older too. One day his mother said to him, "Joseph, look at the blanket. It's frazzled, it's worn, it's unsightly, it's torn. It's time to throw it out." "I can fix it," Joseph said. Joseph's grandfather took the blanket and he turned it around and around. He said, and the scissors went snip, 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 and the needle went in and out and in and out. "There's just enough material here to make a wonderful jacket." Joseph put on his wonderful jacket and went outside to play. But as Joseph grew older, the wonderful blanket jacket grew older too. One day his mother said to him, "Joseph, look at your jacket. It's shrunken and fallen. It doesn't fit you at all. It's time to throw it out." "Grandpa can fix it," Joseph said. And Joseph's grandfather took the jacket and he turned it around and around. He said, and the scissors went snip, 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 and the needle went in and out and in and out. "There's just enough material here to make a wonderful vest." Joseph wore the wonderful vest to school the next day. But as Joseph grew older, the wonderful vest grew older too. One day his mother said to him, "Joseph, look at your vest. It's spotted with glue and there's paint on it too." What do you think she wanted him to do? "It's time to throw it out." "Grandpa can fix it," Joseph said. And Joseph's grandfather took the vest and he turned it around and around. He said, and the scissors went snip, snip, snip. What happened to the needle? It went in and out and in and out. "There's just enough material here to make. What do you think he's going to make? A wonderful tie." Joseph wore the wonderful tie to his grandparents' house every Friday. But as Joseph grew older, the wonderful tie grew older too. One day his mother said to him, "Joseph, look at your tie. This big stain of soot makes the end of it droop. It's time to throw it out." "Grandpa can fix it," he said. But Joseph's grandfather took the tie and he turned it around and around. He said, and the scissors went snip, 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 and his needle flew in and out and in and out. "There's just enough material here to make a wonderful handkerchief." Joseph used the wonderful handkerchief to keep his pebble collection safe. But as Joseph grew older, his wonderful handkerchief grew older too. One day his mother said to him, "Joseph, look at your handkerchief. It's been used till it's tattered, it's splotched, and it's splattered. It's time to..." What does she want him to do? "Throw it out." "Grandpa can fix it," Joseph said. And Joseph's grandfather took the handkerchief and turned it around and around. And the scissors went snip, snip, snip. And the needle went in and out and in and out. "And there's just enough material here to make a wonderful button." Joseph wore the wonderful button to his, on his suspenders to hold his pants up. And one day his mother said to him, "Joseph, where's your button?" And Joseph looked, and it was gone. He searched everywhere, but he couldn't find it. And he ran down to his grandfather's house. "My button, my wonderful button is lost." And his mother ran after him. "Joseph, listen to me. The button is gone, finished, kaput. Even your grandfather can't put something from nothing." Joseph's grandfather shook his head sadly. "I'm afraid your mom is right," he said. The next day, Joseph went to school. He said as he pen went scritch, scratch, scritch, scratch, scritch, scratch over the paper. "There's just enough material here to make a wonderful story." The end.
Awesome. Thank you, Shelley. That was wonderful. I'm going to turn it over to Carly and Daniel, who have something very special planned for us today. Here we go.
I'm actually going to ask Daniel really quick because he's going to teach us some dance moves.
I'm still muted. Hey, hello, everybody. It's Daniel from Camp Shy. It's so fun to see everybody at Havdalah this week. It's also super fun. I've seen a couple Camp Shy kiddos there. So shout outs to you, friends, and future Camp Shires. We're going to learn one of my favorite songs. It's traditionally sung after Havdalah. It's a very, very old song. And the lyrics and the motions and everything are old as well. It's very simple. So let's all learn the motions first. Everything goes in twos. So we're going to start first by slapping our legs on our thighs twice. Everybody follow along. And then we'll clap twice. And then we'll swipe our hands opposite directions twice. Bump our fists twice. And then here's the trickiest one. We can do it. We're gonna put our elbows on top of our hands and flicker our hands like a candle on each side. All right, we're gonna try it again. Thighs twice, clap twice, swipe, fists, and elbows. Perfect. Everybody's doing a great job. Now we're gonna learn the words to each of these parts. They each have a different word. It's super easy. I promise you can get it. Try along. All right, the thighs, it goes David, David. And then we clap Melech, Melech. Yisrael, we're swiping Yisrael. Chai with our fist, Chai, Chai. And then our elbows, here's the tricky one, Vikayam. We're gonna do that. And we're gonna put it all together. Here we go. David, Melech, Yisrael, Chai, Chai, Vikayam. And we do it faster and faster each time. And Carly will help us out here.
Awesome. Here we go, Daniel. David, Melech Yisrael, Chai, Chai, Vikayam. David, Melech Yisrael, Chai, Chai, Vikayam. David, Melech Yisrael, Chai, Chai, Vikayam. Let's do it again. David, Melech Yisrael, Chai, Chai, Vikayam. David, Melech Yisrael, I Wow, those are amazing dance moves. Daniel, you did such a great job teaching.
Thanks, Carly.
Yeah. Now I'll pop it back over to Stephanie.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Daniel. Thank you, Carly. Thank you, Shelly. Thank you, Ryan, for such an awesome Havdalah today. I want to say have an amazing week. I'm really, really excited to see all of you again at 9 a.m. for Shabbat Sing on Friday. And also just a reminder that Ranch Camp and Camp Shy have Facebook posts every day with different activities you can do at home with your children, like weekly campfire songs and so much more. So don't forget to check out the Facebook posts for Ranch Camp and Camp Shy and the ELS's Shabbat Sing on Friday. I hope everyone has an amazing, amazing week. It is so happy to see so many faces here. I hope we can see all of you and more on Friday and then again next Tuesday. Shavua Tov, everyone. Have an amazing week. Mwah!